let's see the ingredients for this rava cake. Here we have rava or suji. This is fine suji or semolina, and this is 1 1/2 cup. 1/2 cup of maida or all-purpose flour, 1 cup of powdered sugar. Then here is cardamom powder. This is 1 teaspoon. Now in this recipe, I'm going to use cardamom powder. You can make use of vanilla essence. Then here is salt, 1/4 teaspoon. 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda and 1 teaspoon of baking powder. These all are dry ingredients. Now here in wet ingredients, we have curd or yogurt. This is 1/2 cup. 1 cup of milk. This is 1/4 cup of melted butter and 1/4 cup of oil. Now here, instead of butter, you can make use of oil. You can take 1/2 cup of oil. But to make this cake richer and to give that Iyengar bakery flavor, I'm using butter over here. And instead of butter, you can also make use of melted ghee. Those who have seen my previous videos, they know very well that I normally bake in this aluminium vessel and I do ovenless baking. And here is a big aluminium vessel, and inside I have placed one ring or stand, and we are just going to preheat this vessel on medium flame for 10 minutes. Similarly, as we preheat our oven, in another bowl we are going to sift our dry ingredients. Here we'll be adding all-purpose flour or maida. To that we'll be adding salt, then baking soda and baking powder, and we'll sift this and we will keep it ready. Going to soak this rava or semolina, and to that we'll be adding milk. Now here I have used the malai also, and now we'll mix it well. We'll add 1 cup of milk, and I'll just mix this very well. We added milk and we mixed it well, and we will keep this aside for 10 to 15 minutes. Now here to another bowl, we will be adding butter and oil. And while using butter or ghee, make sure that you melt it and then you use it. To this, now we will be adding powdered sugar. And we will mix this very well. We have to cream this mixture. We have creamed it well, and to this now we will add yogurt, and again we will mix well. We have to make a nice smooth mixture. Now to this mixture we will be adding cardamom powder, and again we will be mixing it well. It's been 10 minutes now, and you can see the suji or rava has soaked the milk, and now this mixture we are going to add to our yogurt mixture. We'll add this. We will mix it very well. Here you can see the mixture after adding suji, and now to this we'll be adding dry flour, and again we'll mix it well. We have mixed our batter very well. You can see the consistency also. We have taken one round cake tin. This is 8 inches cake tin, and I have added a parchment paper, and now to this we'll be adding our batter. We'll place the cake tin inside. We have placed the cake tin inside, and be very careful as the vessel is hot, and we will cover this again, and we will bake it for 40 to 45 minutes on very low flame. If you are baking in oven, you can bake it at 180 degrees for 40 to 45 minutes. It's been 45 minutes now, and we will just open and we will check. You can see how nicely the cake has risen. But I will bake it for more 10-15 minutes so that we will get nice brown crust on top. It's been 1 hour now, and I'll just open and I'll check. You can see the color difference. We have got nice light brownish shade on top. and crust on the sides. And now we'll just switch off the flame and I'll take this out and we will let it cool. I will just loosen the sides. You can see how nicely it has unmolded. Nice suji cake. I'll just cut and I'll show you. Here you can see the texture. Nice and spongy. And this cake is very easy. Do try it out at home, that too eggless and without oven. I will show you the texture of this cake. You can see. Nice rava cake. And taste wise also it's very nice. Share this recipe with your family and friends and please subscribe to my channel.